Where are we going to do the lights at the tennis court?
When?
When?
I've got a proposal on it, so.
How much?
We just got that, what, this week, yesterday?
$117,000 to outright buy and purchase, that's completely installed, and then we can finance it. I think it was $6,820, and like $120 was $14,700 a year, I think it was.
We want to just buy, wouldn't we?
If we got to pay that, that'd be much better.
It'd be good, that, the pickleball.
What do you want?
My son lives in Dublin, he said the other day, so I'm addicted. He said just.
Look, we went up to, I watched it this past weekend, so at the campground, and went to the Jimmy Johnson concert. And whenever we left on Sunday morning, their courts up there, there's probably 60 people on their courts at 10 o'clock on Sunday. That's how I meant, just.
Where are you going to do more courts?
I mean, eventually, probably, so, we keep on growing up.
They're already working more courts.
Yeah. We're not quite there yet.
I got a sidetrack, I'm sorry.
Are tennis, while you're there, are tennis continuing to use them? I know not the level of pickleball, but.
Yeah, I mean, that's, I mean, you can tell the tennis is broke.
It does, okay, that's good. Okay.
There's more and more people playing tennis each week, something like.
Yeah.
Salaries and wages, a lot of those part-time help?
No, we don't get as few part-timers. A lot of words too, it's like contract labor. Well, a couple people work contract labor on just Saturdays with football. Up and down on the field, concessions team. There's only that's five full-time employees and then three part-time.
Did you say contract labor was in that salary and wages?
No, they're actually, there's a separate line for contract.
And contract services?
Yeah, that's what it's at.
Contract service, yeah.
Last year, we broke out the officials, had officials have it on line.
We should take out the pool part in the back door.
Yeah, we separated it and had to work at its own, where's its own budget.
It's at the, kind of those last six or eight, well, eight or nine lines.
Last page.
Yeah, we've got that O3 modifier.
But we won't even need that next year, will we?
Depends on if it gets, it opens up.
Honestly, it's somewhat, I think.
Yeah, yeah.
Best case would be we only have part of it.
I would love nothing more than do it about budget amendment to bring it back.
Oh, absolutely.
However.
Why are we not showing anything over here? Telephone, supplies and materials.
Well, within the park and rec department, there have been in the past, like the civic center had its own lines.
Yeah, we've got it working separately.
Right. Some of, there are, within the park and rec budget, there are multiple lines for telephone expense, you know, utilities, that kind of thing, because it would have been used in the past for swimming pool related or civic center related or general park and rec related. We kind of split those out, but now they're all just combined. So
we still have the line items, we're just not populating.
Right.
Not yet.
But under communications, we actually have a 2021 figure there. At the bottom of the second page.
Right.
That's what was throwing me, if we had 21 figure, we could have slightly changed 22.
Second page?
Second, or third page?
Third page. Oh, that 02, if you see the account number 160102, that's telephone bills that are related to the civic center specifically. And then the rest of his general parking rec.
Well, we're gonna have that expense, tell them the budget.
Yeah.
Well, it's been, we've combined it with the rest of the parking rec.
That's where our office.
That's where their office and everything is now, so we really don't need to separate it. They have, should be probably on the first page, I guess, maybe y'all's first page. Communications telephone for $6,000.
Yep.
At the bottom?
Yeah, that's where all of their telephone expense is now. They're just, since their office and everything moved to the civic center, we didn't really feel a need to separate all the civic center. And y'all don't really rent the civic center out anymore, do you? Really, yeah?
No, it's just, it's too hard to maintain, nobody else take care of it. It's hard getting, when you do your deposit, it's so minimal, when you keep it, it's very, it's cleaning up with the damages, so. It's just as easy to not pay it out. Especially after they had the, showing you the pictures of the party that they had. And going, a fridge full of beer.
Oh.
Chest fridge. Chest fridge.
Oh, great. Was it a wedding?
It's kind of good.
Yeah, because those Americans don't drink beer. Whatever. But you rent it for, like, Georgia Transmission?
Yeah.
Or let them use it?
If, like, a local church or something like that wants to have a benefit or something like that. But have for that, but no more parties. Yes.
Not the capital request, I don't know what it is. Okay, you sure?
Okay, so the capital request we're talking about. A new restroom for tennis courts. A new restroom for walking trails.
That's the trail number, right?
Yeah, you know, the fish park, that's a very far issue with the BOC. Right, where the loop is, we've got a bathroom there now, it's probably about 17 years old. And I want to move that bathroom away from where it's at now and put it inside the loop, just on the other side of the fish park. But then that way I think I can get the people from hanging out there in paint business. Because that's one of the worst factors we have in there for families. And I want to get rid of the pavilion in this area and move everything, kind of a little bit of walking distance from the parking lot. And plus it is so, it's 17 years old, it's just so hard to keep.
But there's not any cost figures for this, for anything, except for lift stations.
There is on the front, of your, well, actually, Sandy gave it to us yesterday.
Oh.
That separate sheet that says parking rec.
Oh, yeah.
$60,000 for restroom on the walking trail. $62,000 for the tennis. Kevan, so which bathroom do you work with the most?
Both of them. Especially if we're talking live, because That restroom for the tennis courts also includes the electrical room, and has all the electrical for lights, the control valves and stuff like that. So I incorporated it in the same building.
And where do they go to the bathroom now? Inside y'all?
We'll go to the civic center for the most part of the day, but then the restroom is over there, kind of back behind it. It's been there for 20 years now. That's where they go after hours.
Okay.
What's the lift station?
Gregory. That's the tank, to do away with second tank and put it in the force main drain that comes along.
Well, I assume you already connected to that.
No. See, like now, we're pumping that thing 5 to 6 times a season. And this past time, it was pumped in when Gilmer City got there, pumped it with another even, or if our red ball, they would have been in the floor.
Yeah, at least we done the best.
I don't remember why we did.
Go back to Jay City.
I'm not there, but if we go a little bit too long, I'm on eggshells up there walking around, worried that things would happen.
I bet you are. Where are you gonna be walking around on Sunday?
Well, you know, we've got a good relationship with that organization now that comes in and does that World Series. That's before they do. And I'm gonna have Norman come up on every day. He's got to come every morning. So they're bringing, this past time they brought 62 teams to town for 4 days. Just that impact alone covers the pump, covers the pump.
Any idea how all the tickets and all that done? I mean, is there supplies available?
I talked to Fred this morning. He said that he's in there, he's still being there for seats. So I want to make sure that the code is back. Still good because of all the increases in price. He says it should still be good.
Well, at 48,000, it's under 50, so we wouldn't have to bid it, but we would have to get two quotes.
Or you got a number?
Okay.
You have to hire this one.
Okay. Don't forget,